Normal Consumer here, and today I'm going to give you a few tips on how to save as much money as possible on upgrading your smartphone. Now, if you're like me, or countless others around the world, you keep up with the smartphone world. And by keep up, I mean you want the latest and greatest smartphone on the market, whether that be the new Apple iPhone, the new Samsung Galaxy, Vivo Find X, Xiaomi Mi, etc. You want it. But those upgrades can be expensive if you don't subsidize it. Now, before I get too deep into the video, as usual, if I can make you chuckle before the end of this video, if you learn something new, if you like how I'm rocking, or if you like my vibe, go ahead, like, and subscribe. And while you're at it, hit that bell icon to turn on notifications. That way, ding, you know when I upload something new. And back to it. Okay, guys, it's no secret that new Flagship smartphones cost a pretty penny. Hell, some of them cost more than proper laptops, especially if you want the best from Samsung or Apple. You can expect to cough up at least $1,000, but there are always ways to avoid paying the full price of these new smartphones. Tip number one, take advantage of carrier holiday deals. See, carrier stores sometimes are the easiest place to get a new smartphone, especially here in the United States. The problem with carrier stores are they have lengthy installment agreements, aka contracts. But it is all bad. The carrier stores usually have deals going on throughout the year. A lot of them happen around holidays, and Fat Mother's Day just passed, and the carriers had special deals. And this is one of the best things carrier stores have going for them. Whether it's Mother's Day, Father's Day, graduation season, you can rest assured there will be some kind of deal going on. Get one free, buy one, get one free, buy one, get one half off, etc. And these deals apply to popular flagships, including iPhones and Galaxies. Now, the downside to these deals is you are still tied into an installation agreement. So yeah, you save money, but you're still stuck with your carrier for another 2 or 3 years. It could be a deal breaker if you are upset with your current carrier. Tip two, turn your old devices. Other deals carriers offer are used only around holidays, but many times carriers offer plenty of great trade-in deals. A lot of those happen generally when new devices are about to come out. And see, these deals usually require you to completely own your phone. That means no installment plans can be active. So if you're patient and can wait until your device is completely paid off, then you can save a lot of money on a new phone. Now on the flip side, if you aren't the most patient buyer out there is still hope. You can always sell your phone yourself. Of course, this isn't as easy as walking into your local Verizon, but you can usually get more money than the carrier will give you, especially for iPhones and Galaxies. See, I personally like using Swappa. Well, I need to get rid of a device. I've bought and sold devices on Swappa, and every time it's been a smooth experience. There's also Gazelle, which is another website where you can sell your old device. Heck, you can even go to one of those eco ATMs that are all over the place, especially in malls. I'll put the links for these down in the description, but remember, selling an older device yourself can take longer, much longer than going to a carrier store. But the potential trade-off of pocketing more cash is definitely worth it in my book. Tip three, do you really need a flagship device? The iPhone Pro line, Galaxy S and Z line, and other flagship lines get all the attention when it comes to device releases. But it doesn't mean that they're the only devices worth buying. In fact, Samsung Galaxy A series of devices is a great choice for anyone who doesn't need the highest end specs. The A series offers out plenty of features that the S devices have at a more reasonable price. There's also the Samsung Galaxy FE devices. These fan edition devices are close in features, but cheaper than the Galaxy S devices. There are plenty of mid-range devices from Samsung, Motorola, Apple, other manufacturers that do most of the same things as these flagships. See, the point is, you can find a device that fits your budget without needing to cough up all the money. A salesman might say spend $1,300 even if your budget's only $500. Look, we've got to a point in smartphone development where even mid-range devices are more than capable of offering fantastic day-to-day performance. Tip four, be patient. This last tip is kind of a no-brainer, but if your current phone works fine and you're happy with it, then just wait. Sure, you have the newest iPhone being advertised everywhere when it launches, but ask yourself, do you really need it? See, most phones from Apple, Samsung, and Google are supported for at least 4 years. This is a huge improvement from where we were just 5 years ago, where Apple was the only one to offer this kind of support. Thanks to these companies offering longer software support, you can safely keep using your phone that is 2, 3, or even 4 years old. This means your device will continue to receive security updates to keep you safe from vulnerabilities. Heck, you might even get a few new features. Now, you're probably thinking, why is this video even relevant? Because there are people who still think it would cost them an arm and a leg to get a new phone. Seriously, guys, last year I was working at Verizon, and the amount of people who came in not knowing they could get cheap or free phones was astounding. Either that or they assumed they needed the newest device on the market. I talked a fair amount of people out of getting the iPhone 13 Pro and even the normal 13. And all I did was give the specs about the new phone versus their current phone, and they decided it was best to keep their current phone. Hey, not all salesmen or saleswomen are snakes, just letting you know. But hopefully this knowledge can help some of you. And if you already know and already savvy when it comes to saving money on upgrades, then share this with someone who isn't. And of course, as usual, I made you chuckle before the end of this video. If you learned something new, if you like how I'm rocking, or if you like my vibe, go ahead, like and subscribe. And while you edit, hit the bell icon to turn those notifications. That way, ding, you know when I upload something new. And don't forget to let me know what you think down in the comments. It's been Norman Consumer. I'll see you guys in the next one.